In this video, we are going to discuss about data types and data structures in R. So let's start with discussing what is data type. Data type of a value is an attribute that tells about the kind of data that value can have. So it is simply means they are the characteristics of the data we are using in our software program or any language that we are using. There are different kinds of data types in R. First is character. So character means a letter form, alphabetical form, in which it can be a single letter or a group of letters like A, you can store a A, or a group of letters like data signs, or name, address, it can be anything. Numeric data type means it can be a whole number, it can be a fraction, decimal, any part. Integers, they are the whole numbers or non-fractional values like 4, 6, 8. In R language, we add an capital L to that integer number, so that it can be saved in the form of integer. Next is logical. Logical data type means is the value true or false. Complex data type means it is a combination of real and imaginary part that there should be a number along with any of the alphabet or a imaginary part. Next are data structures. So data structures are very important in any language. Data structure is a storage format that enables efficient access or modification of the data. There are different kinds of data structures that we use in R. First is vector, second is matrices, arrays, list, and data frames. So let's start with vectors. Vectors are the simplest form of data structures. It is a series of data elements. They are combined in the form of a sequence. A vector should be in only one data type, either numeric, integer, character, or logical or complex. So let's go to R and start writing the codes. I have already written the codes to save the time. So let's start with numeric vector. So I am saving the value in x variable. I am creating a variable x where I'll be saving values 2, 3, and 4. Here C means that I am combining these letters, these numbers, and forming a vector. So let's create this variable. After execution, I can check the value in the x. So I'll simply put x here and control enter. So you can see the value that I have stored in vector x is 2, 3, and 4. Now function to check the class of that vector. It is class, and in the bracket parenthesis, it is x, the name of that vector. So it is numeric, as we can see. Next is length. Length shows the how long is that vector, how many values are there in that vector. So we can see there are three values in this vector. Similarly, it can be in character data type. Whenever we are creating a vector with a character data type, it should be in whenever we are creating a character vector. So here I am saving my characters in a variable y. I am combining A, B, and C, and they, whenever we save a character, it should be in inverted commas so that it can be saved in the form of character. I have entered the value. Now let's check the value of y variable, and we can see A, B, and C are saved in y variable. Now let's check the class of y. So we can see it is in the form of character. These variables are stored in the form of character. Similarly, we can create a logical vector, same way entering the values of true and false, integers. So here you can see that for saving integers, I have added a capital L to the value. Now let's check the class of this variable. So you can see it is saved in the form of integers. Now next is adding an element to the vector. Now I have already created a vector of the character. You can see here it is y. Y variable was in character vector, and now we are adding an element to that vector. What we will do is in same variable we are adding d in it. So first we'll give the same variable name, comma, the element that you want to add. So let's execute this command. So I have given in y variable I want to add d. Now let's check y variable. So you have seen that earlier there were a, b, c. Now there are a, b, c, and d. Another way to create a vector is you can directly give a variable name, like I have given here a series, and I have given 1:10. It means that I want to save vector from 1 to 10 value. Let me just print this value. I'm writing the name of the variable and control plus enter. You can see I have created a vector from 1 to 10. We can also check the class of this variable. So you can see, let's print the value of series variable. And you can see there are 1 to 10 saved in this variable. Similarly, there is a command called seq that is sequence, and I am giving in the brackets number 10. So it means I want to create a sequence with values 1 to 10. It automatically prints it because I have not saved it in any variable. So it is directly printing the values from 1 to 10. Next, what I am doing is I am creating a sequence starting with 1, ending with 10, and with an interval of 1.5. So let's print this value, and you can see there is 1, and after that there is 2.5, 4, 5.5. So there is a gap of 1.5 after each number. Let's go back to the next is matrix. Matrix, it's a collection of elements. So there are fixed number of rows and columns. So it means it is a two-dimensional data structure but there should be only one data type in whole matrix. It means the rows and columns should be either in numeric form or character or logical or any other, but only one data type. Now let's create matrix. So the command to create a matrix is we give matrix, and within brackets we first provide the data like what, from where to which end you want that the values to be saved in that matrix. You give the number of rows and columns, and you give the value by the logical value, that is, if you want your values to be filled by rows, so it should be true. If you want them to be filled in columns first, so it should be true. It should be false. Then you can give the dimension names. That is, you can give the names of the row and columns. So I am creating a matrix here, and I am saving the matrix in variable m. My command is matrix, and I am giving values 1 to 10. Where there should be two rows and 5 columns. So how do I decide how many columns and how many rows should be there? So you can see I have 10 values, and it should be in the multiple only. Otherwise, it will give you an error that rows and column combination is not there. Now let's print this value. So you can see there are 2 rows and 5 columns with the numbers values from 1 to 10. So I'm checking the dimensions. To check the dimensions of matrix, the formula and the command is dim, that is dimension within brackets, name of the variable. So you can see it gives the row and columns. First one is the row, second one is the column. In second command, what I am doing is I am providing the number, the values to be filled in matrix. Then I have given the rows number. Column, it will take by default. Like I have given 3 rows, there are 6 numbers. So 2, 3 is 6, it can go that ways. By rows, I have done true. So it means the values will be filled by row first. Then there is dim names, that is dimension names. So whenever you are giving the values, the names of the dimension directly, it should be in the form of list. Like command should be dim name equal to list, combining first are the names of rows, then there is name of columns. Let's execute this command, and you can see what I have done is I have given the brackets first, and in the end it will directly print that command. So I have given the names, the row name as def and column names as b, a, and b. So in first command, in this command, I have done filling by rows. So I have given true here. Now I want to fill my matrix column wise. So what I'm doing is by row is false. Now let's print this. So you can see the values have changed. Earlier, what I have given was in rows equal to 3 and by row true. So what was the structure of the matrix? There were 3 rows and 2 columns, but when I did false, it became 3